as you're sitting. Good morning and welcome to St. Ambrose. Our opening song today is in the Breaking Bread hymnal, which is in the pews, number 48, Beyond the Moon and Stars. Number 48. Please stand. We will sing verses 1, 2, and 5.
God is good
all the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
So I want to welcome you all to the celebration of the life of our dear sister Laura. who has been a very active member of this parish and a choir member. So that is why we are all here today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Laura died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Laura, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if to human sight they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. As gold in the furnace, those who trust in the Lord shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord. of whom should I be, I pray? Of whom should I be afraid?
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To Luke.
Glory to you, O God.
It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." And when he had said this, he breathed his last. Now there was a virtuous and righteous man named Joseph, who, though he was a member of the council, went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. After the body had been taken down, he wrapped it in a linen cloth and laid him in a rock-hewn tomb in which no one yet had been buried. But at daybreak on the first day of the week, the women took spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were puzzling over this, behold, two men in dazzling garments appeared to them. They were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. They said to them, "Why do you seek the living one among the dead? He is not here, but he has arisen." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
for our sister Laura what that virtuous man Joseph did for Jesus. We take loving care of the mortal remains of her body, burying them in a place of respect, even of prayer. And our prayer in the presence of her ashes, in our prayer, we commend her soul to the eternal care of Jesus, whose love for her and for us led him to choose a difficult path and follow it to its bitter end. From me, many things about Laura's Christian journey are unknown. How did she come to choose nursing as a life work? When did the message of hope and life and peace that is the gospel of Jesus so impress itself on her that she gave her life to him? How did she find her way into the Catholic Church? These things are unknown to me. God gave Laura many personal gifts, including a remarkable voice. We didn't really hear her sing. I never heard her sing until a few years ago, but I didn't hear her sing as a soloist until a few months ago. She had a voice with some power in it, some nice, pure tones, but in kind of a lower range than a flute. She and her doggie occupied a special place in the choir. I never knew Laura without her canine companion Twist, and I sometimes wondered how a nice, friendly creature like that ever graduated from therapy school. Twist seemed to me a perfect name for a squirmy, friendly companion pet. It really needed a leash and occasionally took advantage of the fact that Laura's attention was going in some other direction. I've heard from some of you that Laura was a successful animal trainer and obedience teacher. My mother would have liked to have some of those skills, not so much with the animals. I have heard also that Laura has had several companion dogs across the years. Remy, who like Twist, was a golden dog. Nessie, a bull mastiff. I had to look that up in Wikipedia today just to see what that looks like. That is a great looking dog. I heard that she had Nessie, named after a monster in a lake over in Scotland because he was strong. She also had a friendly dog named Bubba that fell in love with Linda Seeger's Dalmatian Dottie, and that brought Linda and Laura together in friendship. Laura both trained dogs and learned from them. She came to recognize Twist's ability to detect a potentially deadly disease in Laura's friends. And when Twist showed the telltale behavior, Laura, after some should I, shouldn't I questioning, was able to encourage the affected person not to dawdle over their treatment. For her sister Linda,
Laura was the person to whom she could turn for answers to questions about animals or about human medical concerns. And is it true that sometimes she gave you the right idea? Laura shared with her father some of her major interests, their Scottish heritage and family history, and the Mad Dogs and Englishmen Car Club. She was a hobby yarn spinner, I mean in the literal sense. I think she made spinning yarns more than a hobby. And she easily made friends through those varied interests. It helped that she had a ready sense of humor, cheerful disposition, and an encouraging soul. Some of you have shared with me your belief that her mother's death powerfully influenced the direction of Laura's life. I have the impression that Laura dedicated her life, not just her place in the family, but her career and even her friendships. She dedicated her life to honoring God in the choir here, in helping people with their dogs, in her nursing, with her dad, with whom she shared lots of meals and good times. None of us knows where life will lead us. I am sure, though, of this much. God placed Laura in our lives for our sake and for hers, so that we could love her, so that she could love us, along with the animals and the people associated with them. Sometimes I've heard people muse about why they're here, why at an advanced age they continue in this life. I know that it has to do with the love of God for us and the trust that God's love desires to awaken in us. I mean that when we say, God loved the world so much that he sent his only begotten Son so that all who believe in him might not perish but might have eternal life. When we say that, we mean that God loves us so that we could respond to him with trusting love. Jesus, the eternal Son of the Father, lived in that loving trust from the beginning of his life on earth to the end of it. I consider that Laura did that for some significant part of her life. As Jesus trusted his life to God, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit, so he entrusted his death to the Father as well. Passage from the Book of Wisdom begins with these encouraging words. The souls of the just are in the hand of God. May Laura's own life and witness help us to place ourselves in God's hands too. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
May she live forever in peace. Amen.
Let us now arise and then offer our prayers and our petitions on behalf of our sister Laura.
For Laura, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister Laura, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Laura, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now invite the intercession of our Blessed Mother as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated as we prepare the altar for Holy Communion.
Be still and open up your mind.
Please arise. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Laura, we beseech your mercy that she, who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. remember your servant Laura, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all our beloved brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we too may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other some sign of Christ's peace.
Peace, 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 peace. It's good to see you. Peace, everybody.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Thank you.
Those of you who are going to receive communion may come forward now by the center aisle. The others may remain seated.
Body of Christ.
So maybe. Okay, so just before the final commendation, I want to take this opportunity to thank you for coming to celebrate the life of our dear sister Laura. So I want to thank the family and friends, and also to thank our choir. You see, they have come in, it's almost a full choir. So thank you so much, our dear choir, for doing this. She must be very happy in heaven. And also thank Father Mike and Deacon Hal. And also thank me too. And Father Albert, for those who may be very new to me. So let's continue accompanying the family with our prayers. Especially as we continue commending our dear sister Laura to the Lord. So my dear friends, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Let us take our sister.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Just a reminder that after this, we have a luncheon in honor of our dear sister at the other building across the parking lot. Let us now stand. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our sister Laura in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Laura in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, Laura, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our dear sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now let us take our sister to her final resting place.
Amen.
Our closing song is in the Breaking Bread hymnal, number 476, Fly Like a Bird.
Alone.